show that summation n is equal to infinite 1 by n log n is divergent. Now we have to prove this infinite series is divergent. For that, we are comparing the given series with the summation f of n. So, we can say f of n is equal to 1 by n log n. You see, we know that n is greater than 0. So, n is a natural number, so greater than 0, positive. Log n is also positive. So, n into log n is positive. Then 1 by n log n is also positive. So, the series is a positive term of the series. And as n is increases, then f of n is decreases. If it is f of n, consider as f of x. In place of n, if we replace it by x, it will become f of x. F of x is equal to 1 by x log x. You see, this series is decreasing series as n increases. Decreases in where? From 2 to infinite. Decreases from 2 to infinite. And which is a positive? Nothing but the given series is non-negative decreasing function in 2 to infinite. So, this is f of x. No? To test the series convergent by integral test, we have to verify integral 2 to infinite f of x dx. Improper integral we have to evaluate. This improper integral gives a finite value, then you can say the series summation f of n is convergent. If it is infinite value, then you can say the series is divergent. Okay, now we have applying integral on both sides, then integral 2 to infinite f of x dx is equal to integral 2 to infinite 1 by x log x dx. You see, this is improper integral, so we are taking this is limit. Consider t tends to infinite, nothing but at infinite we can replace with t. So that is limit from 2 to t 1 by x log x dx. Now you see, this is you have 1 by x log x, 1 by x log x, product of two functions in the denominator. So you see, you have a formula like f dash of x by f of x dx. This is a fractional function. So either this form or also f dash of x into fn of x dx form also. If it is not in this one, then you have a formula. You see, bracket derivative is beside. Then integral of this one is bracket power plus 1 by power plus 1. Or else denominator derivative, if it is in numerator, then you will write log of denominator. Now I am writing this as integral 2 to infinite. This x is in the numerator, then log x dx. Now you observe, this is if we consider the denominator is f of x. F of x derivative is what? F dash of x. That is log x derivative is 1 by x. So denominator derivative is in numerator. This is 2 to t. Denominator derivative is in the numerator. Then we will write log of denominator. So log of log x. Log of log x. Limits from 2 to t. Limit t tends to infinite. Upper limit is log of log t minus log of log 2. Log of log t minus log of log 2. Okay. Now this is equal to, apply the t tends to infinite, then log of log infinite minus log of log 2. You see, log 2 value is small and log of log 2 is also small. Okay, it is the finite value only. Now log infinite. Log infinite is what? Infinite. Log of log infinite becomes infinite. So infinite minus small value becomes what? Infinite only. So the limit is what you have now? Infinite. So the integral 2 to infinite f of x dx is what? Infinite. If we have limit is infinite, then the given series is what you can say? Divergent. Therefore, by integral test, summation f of n is divergent. Summation f of n is divergent. By which test? Integral test. Like this we can solve in the integral test.